Hey everyone, Intel's mid-range 700 series chipsets have just dropped, alongside a whole slew of new low to mid-range 13th generation Raptor Lake CPU offerings. For today's video, we'll be taking a look at an Intel B760 motherboard targeted at budget-conscious gamers, the Gigabyte B760M Gaming X AX DDR4. Sporting support for Intel's 13th gen Raptor Lake CPUs, all while serving up DDR4 support. Let's see if this board is any good. Now, the B760M Gaming X AX DDR4 that we have here today, as its name implies, sports the new Intel B760 chipset and sits within the Gaming X series of motherboard offerings targeted at gamers on a budget, where it places below the Aorus series of boards and above the value-oriented ultra-durable series of motherboard offerings by Gigabyte. In keeping with the design language of the Gaming X series of products, the B760M Gaming X AX DDR4 comes in a box sporting an orange on black color scheme with an Iron Man-ish kind of character emblazoned on the front for good measure. Moving over to the rear of the box, we get the usual summary of specs for this board. We'll take a closer look at these specs later on in this video. On a side note, if you're new to the ALK Tech channel, do consider subscribing so as to keep up to date with the latest product releases in the PC hardware world. Let's set aside the board for now to see what accessories Gigabyte has included with it. First up, we get a Wi-Fi antenna right here. And this is accompanied by two SATA 3 cables. We do also get a spare M.2 drive screw and a quick start guide right here. With that, onto the board itself. With the board out of the packaging, we see that Gigabyte has gone for a black and grey colour scheme. The board comes with an integrated I/O shield design and has black coloured heatsinks all around. RGB junkies should note that this board does not come with built-in RGB LED accents, though it does of course come with a handful of onboard RGB headers. I'll talk about the locations of these headers later on in this video. The VRM heatsinks for this board seem pretty decently sized, and Gigabyte has included 8+1+1 power stages. The Intel B760 chipset sits beneath this passive heatsink right here. And for M.2 drive cooling, Gigabyte has included a M.2 drive heatsink for one out of the two M.2 drive slots that this board comes with. For memory support, the B760M Gaming X AX DDR4 comes with four DDR4 slots, not DDR5, with support for up to 128GB of RAM and the DDR4 5333 standard when overclocked, with plastic slots of a dual tab design. In terms of front panel USB connectivity, we get a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type-C front panel header and beneath it, a USB 3.2 Gen 1 front panel header that supports up to two front panel USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports. While still on the topic of front panel USB connectivity, the bottom edge of the board houses two USB 2.0 front panel headers, with each header providing support for two USB 2.0 Type-A ports. Some interesting features to highlight: we get a Q-Flash Plus button right here that allows you to update the BIOS without needing to install a CPU, RAM, or graphics card. We also get an onboard reset switch that can be remapped by end users within the BIOS to serve different functions, such as to switch on and off the RGB lighting effects of supported peripherals that are connected to the board, and so on. Moving on, we get Thunderbolt headers right here that allow you to hook up a Thunderbolt add-on card that is sold separately by Gigabyte, as well as a serial port header, which could come in useful for situations that call for the use of legacy PC hardware. In terms of expansion slots, this board comes with a reinforced PCIe 4.0 x16 slot that sports the Easy Latch feature. Easy Latch is essentially an oversized graphics card retention tab that helps make removing a graphics card from the board less of a painful affair. We do also get a full-length PCIe 3.0 x16 slot that operates at X4 mode. In the storage department, Gigabyte has included four SATA 3 ports, with two ports in a right-angled configuration and the remaining two ports in a straight-angled configuration. For M.2 slots, it comes with two PCIe 4.0x4 M.2 slots. Do note that these two slots support NVMe SSDs only. M.2 SATA drives are not supported. For audio, Gigabyte has included an entry-level Realtek ALC-897 audio codec, while wired internet connectivity is courtesy of Realtek's RTL8125BG chip that provides support for 2.5 gigabit Ethernet. Wi-Fi support, on the other hand, is courtesy of AMD's RZ608 Wi-Fi 6E part that also serves up Bluetooth 5.2 connectivity. In the cooling and RGB departments, the board comes with four fan headers that are located in these regions of the board. Also included are two addressable RGB headers and two 12-volt standard RGB headers located right here. Moving over to the rear I/O, as you can see, the B760M Gaming X AX DDR4 goes for an integrated I/O shield design. The board comes with four USB 2.0 Type-A ports, Wi-Fi antennae connectors, a DisplayPort 1.2 connector that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, a HDMI 2.0 port that supports display output of up to 4K resolution at 60Hz, three USB 3.2 Gen 1 Type-A ports, a USB 2.0 Type-A port that supports QFlash Plus, a 2.5 gigabit Ethernet port, as well as your usual audio jack connectors. With that, the Gigabyte B760M Gaming X AX DDR4 is a value-oriented microATX Intel B760 motherboard offering that checks the right boxes when it comes to its features, where it even serves up 2.5 gigabit Ethernet and Wi-Fi 6E at its price point. One issue to think about, though, is the value proposition that low to mid-range Intel B760 boards have against motherboards powered by its predecessor chipset, the Intel B660. That is, while such B660 boards are still available to purchase new on the market. If you're able to find new B660 boards for cheap, you might find that the incremental improvements from the B760 chipset might not be worth the additional cost, where the money saved from getting a new B660 board could be put to use on other components instead. With that, thank you so much for watching, hit the like button and get subscribed if you've enjoyed this video, and I'll catch you guys around the next time.